Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I am going to review all K-beauty products that I have. Well, I have a lot of K-beauty products to be honest now. So I have most of the products from their range. So I'm gonna apply it on my face and I'm gonna review them, talk about what I feel about their products and talk about their, you know, what they miss, what they are really good in. And I'm doing this because I have posted this story yesterday and many of you pointed that you guys want this review. So I'm doing it for you guys and I'm super excited to do this. And yeah, if you want to know all about King Beauty products, do keep on watching. तो के ब्यूटी प्रोडक्ट्स के रेंज में आपको ना ही फाउंडेशन ना ही कंसीलर्स मिलेंगे, आपको मॉइस्चराइज़र या प्राइमर भी नहीं मिलेगा. तो मैंने ऑलरेडी अपना मॉइस्चराइज़र और प्राइमर यूज़ कर लिया है. सिर्फ आपको कॉन्टोर स्टिक्स और करेक्टर स्टिक्स मिलेंगे उनके रेंज में. मेरे पास यहाँ पे पूरा रेंज है करेक्टर एंड कॉन्टोर स्टिक्स का. तो मैं स्टार्ट करूँगी करेक्टर से. एज यू कैन सी, आई हैव फ्यू डार्क एरियाज ऑन माई फेस, लाइक अंडर माई आईज एंड अराउंड दिस एरिया. तो उसके लिए हम गोना यूज द पीच करेक्टर. करेक्टर्स जो भी है उनके वेबसाइट में अवेलेबल, 5 डिफरेंट शेड्स में अवेलेबल है एंड ईच करेक्टर विल कॉस्ट यू 599 rupees. तो आइए करेक्टर यूज करके देखते हैं कि किस हिसाब से ये करेक्टर है. वेरी इजी टू अप्लाई, इट जस्ट लाइक अ पेंसिल दैट यू जस्ट ड्रॉ इट विद. What I'm also going to do is I'm going to take the orange corrector and I am going to apply this so that it gives me a better, you know, coverage. Now I'm going to use my Wet Beauty Blender and blend this. Well, to be honest, it did blend it out but not that nicely, and it did clogged up. It is very lightweight product, I must say. But it did not give me that much coverage as I really wanted. So I'm gonna use a little bit more and I'm gonna just try to blend it with my finger. The color corrector that I really like is the Bobbi Brown color corrector. It does comes in a dark peach shade. It also blends out into the skin very nicely. I'm not comparing this one with the Bobbi Brown one, but just saying, I love that color corrector. To be honest, I'm not too happy with the color corrector. It did not give me that much coverage, but let me just see. I will apply my foundation and concealer and then we will see how much coverage it gave me. You guys saw that how much I applied, lekin itna zyada, you know, kuch better mujhe abhi to nahi dikh raha hai. Let me just do my foundation and concealer. For foundation today, I'm gonna use the MAC foundation. This is NC30. So I have foundation अच्छे से लगा लिया है, but I can still see some darkness here. But I still have to use my concealers. So for the first concealer, I'm gonna use the LA Girl Pro HD concealer. This is in the shade Pure Beige. Now I'm gonna use the Maybelline Fit Me Concealer. This is in the shade 20. I'm gonna use this to just highlight my face a little bit. I do not really like the color correctors, to be honest, because I can still see some darkness around my eyes. Alright, let's just move ahead. I have two powders from K-Beauty. The first one is the Illuminating Loose Powder, which we're gonna use later because it's the highlighter powder that the company just launched and I have received both of them yesterday. And this one is the setting loose powder. I have not opened this package yet, so I'm opening it right here. These loose powders comes in 8 different shades. I have the shade Latte. It also comes in a white translucent shade. I'm just gonna open this. The packaging looks really pretty. And the product itself looks really premium. The price of this product is 799 rupees. Let me just open it. It does not comes with a puff through which you can apply the powder, so you have to like take this seal off. If you can see, there's a seal and I'm just taking this off. All right so I'm just quickly gonna go ahead and just blend the concealers out again. so that nothing is like there to crease. And now I'm quickly gonna go take this powder and apply it. It is mattifying the concealer. This area looks way too brighter than this area. I don't know, because of the mattifying effect it does have, or there's something. It's reminding me of the Inglot mattifying loose powder that I have. It is definitely reminding me of that. All right, so it did what it says, but I did not like the fact that it did, you know, oxidized my concealer. Like, you can see the difference. Here the skin looks way too yellow, then here it looks way too orangey. Why is it happening? Is it because of the shade that I picked? I think I should have picked the white translucent shade. I don't know why it happened, though I have the latte shade. I thought it is way too bright than my own skin, but I don't know why it is giving me a orange kind of a look. But it did mattify my face completely, so that is one good thing. But I don't know why it just changed my complete color of my face, the places that I use the powder. I'm gonna use one of the contour stick that I have from the K-Beauty range, and today I'm gonna use the Caramel Focus. I know I have used powder and now I'm using a stick again, but I was just trying out a product, okay? So no hard feelings. I'm just gonna use my regular contour brush, which is Wet n Wild brush. Okay, it is blending out nicely. So yeah, it did give me a kind of a little bit of definition to my face. These contour sticks comes in 3 different shades, and the price of each stick is 599 rupees. It did blend it out really well, though. However, I have already used the powder to mattify my concealers, but it still blended out really, really nice with the help of my brush. Now I'm gonna quickly move ahead and start with my eyes. The first thing that I have here and I'm gonna use is the eyebrow pencil. So these brow pencils comes in 3 different shades, and the price of these are 599 rupees. I have the walnut shade with me. I'm just gonna draw my eyebrows with it, and with the help of a spoolie. It does not come with a spoolie though. With the help of a different spoolie, which I have here, I'm gonna blend everything out. So I'm done with my eyebrows. Let's just talk about the product. The product is not too pigmented, which is very, very good for an eyebrow pencil, because you don't want those harsh lines to be drawn on your eyebrows, and then it's very hard for you to blend it. Thoda sa dry hai ye pencil, rather than to be a little bit more waxier part. So yeah, less pigmentation good, but less wax has me. But overall, it did give me a beautiful eyebrow shape, and it does not comes with a spoolie, which is a bummer. Ek spoolie de dete to zyada better hota to use it, because then you don't have to carry another like separate spoolie, or you don't have to buy a separate spoolie for it. Overall, the product is not bad. I really like the color. It is also matching with my hair color, so it gives a very, very natural feel. And to be honest, the wax part is a little less, but not that bad. So K-Beauty has these kind of eyeshadows. These are Metal Show eyeshadow stick. They also have matte in this range as well. So they have total 12 colors in this entire range. I have 6 colors with me. Today I'm gonna use a very, very recent buy of mine. This is Indulge. It also came yesterday. This one is a matte time eyeshadow stick, so I'm gonna use this today. How Katrina shows is just apply them and blend it with your finger. I'm gonna do that. I'm not gonna use any brushes today. So I'm just gonna grab this one. This is in the shade Indulge. I'm just gonna put the Indulge shade onto my crease. And with the help of my finger, I'm just gonna blend this out. If you don't like those bulky eyeshadows, you can definitely go for these because these are super lightweight and is you will not feel that you're wearing any eyeshadow. And to be honest, I'm really liking the way it is blending. How pretty is this? I'm just gonna do this eye and I'm gonna come back. So now that the upper part is done, I'm just gonna put that on the lower area of my eye. And with the help of a brush, I'm just gonna blend that out. And to be honest, it's blending out really, really nice with a brush as well. So I'm quickly gonna show you the colors that I have in the eyeshadow range. The first one that I'm gonna swatch is the Starry Night. It is a black color eyeshadow with a hint of sparkly silver glitters. So this is how the Starry Nights look. The next one I'm gonna swatch here is Blushed Moonlight, copper kind of a shade, not true copper, but you know, mixed with a blush and copper kind of shade. This is how the Blushed Moonlight looks. Next I have here is the Golden Hour. It is a golden color eyeshadow, truly metallic, very, very pretty. Next one is Indulge that I have just applied on to my crease, and very beautiful, very dark color, but if you just smoke it out, it just blends out really, really pretty. This is Indulge. Now I have here Navigator. It is a very beautiful blue color pigment, and you can see how powdery the shades looks like. Very, very pretty. Again, if I'm like swatching this, this is coming super pigmented and very nicely it is coming to the skin. This one is Temptation and it is kind of a reddish maroonish shade, but very pretty metallic shade. This is, again, if you blend this out, it becomes soft and very pretty. I am really impressed with the eyeshadows that K-Beauty has. I'm just gonna take the Golden Hour. I'm just gonna put that to the inner corner. I'm just gonna blend this a little bit. So this is how the eyeshadows are looking. I think these are really, really pretty colors. Now, I don't have K-Beauty eyeliners. It does come in 8 different shades and it costs $4.99 one eyeliner. I don't have the eyeliner. I don't think it is required because I do have 2 different kajals from the range. The first kajal is a very basic kajal. It is a smudge proof kajal. This is 249 rupees. It only comes in this shade. Then I have the gel kajal from the range. It is in the shade O-Nots. It does cost 450 rupees. The formula of this is a gel based. So I'm gonna use this one and I'm just gonna create a very, very light wing liner. Now I'm quickly gonna take a brush and I'm gonna smudge the kajal a little bit before it just sets. Bahut hi amazing smoke out effect aaya hai and I'm really loving the look it gave me. To be honest, I really like the gel kajal because the fact it does have a gel kind of finish and it does not move after it is set. And the pricing is also very well put. 450 rupees for this gel kajal is not bad. I am in love with this one. Now the next product that I have here is the K-Beauty mascara. It does come in one color, which is black. The cost of this product is 799 rupees. So to be honest, out of curiosity, I used this mascara yesterday and I was blown away with this mascara. I'm just gonna use this and I'm gonna show you why I said so. So before applying the mascara, I'm just curling my lashes a little bit. It does comes in this fuller kind of a spoolie, and the application wise, it is super amazing. It just goes into every lash and just brings out the length, and you know, It's just amazing. I'll show you why I'm saying it. Now I'm coming near to the camera and I hope it just... Okay, now you can clearly see why I'm saying it is one of the amazing mascaras that I have used. It did give me the length, the volume. This one is so much better. It looks more sluttier. It looks more fuller. And this eye, it just plain, it does not have any lashes. It does not look like I have any lashes in this eye, but this one is so pretty. I mean, look at that and look at that. Can you see the difference? Oh my god. So normally I just love the L'Oreal mascara. I'll just put the picture here. This one I really love, this one, the K-Beauty mascara, is my second love now. I really love how nice it is, and it is not clogging up to the lashes, just giving that fan and beautiful look. The next product that I'm gonna use is this highlighter powder. This is HD Illuminating Loose Powder Enriched with Avocado and Mango Butter. So this illuminating powder only comes in this shade, Classic Gold. Price of this product is again 799 rupees. I'm a little spectacle how I'm gonna apply this, but look at the packaging, guys. I love it. It looks so damn premium. Now I'm gonna open this. It does comes with this kind of packaging inside with no brush or no puff to apply the powders. I'm gonna open this. This is how the powders look like. I'm a little worried how I'm gonna apply this. I think I'm gonna apply it with the help of my brush. I think that's the perfect way of using this because it's a highlighter powder. So yeah, I have taken a little bit onto my brush, dusting off the excess. And let me just try it onto my nose and see how nice it is. Okay, it is something. Can you see? Okay, this powder is pretty. It does give me kind of a sheen and very soft and subtle look, but you know, I'm not that subtle in makeup. Let me just grab one of my finishing mist and then we're gonna do it in this part and see how, you know, what's the difference if we use the setting spray and then use the powder, how different it's going to look. So guys, I have the color bar finishing mist. I'm gonna apply it in this area of my face. The mist went into my mouth. K-Beauty range does not have any blush on yet. I hope they soon gonna get that out as well. If they come out with foundation and concealer, I'll really look forward to try them out. It does not make a lot of difference, but like a little bit different. So okay, we have to take this as a very light, you know, powder, not bam on other people's face, but a very light and a very sheen kind of a highlighting powder. So I have this 4 lip liners from K-Beauty. Normally these comes in 12 different shades and the price of each shade is 550 rupees. I'm just gonna quickly swatch this for you and show you how it looks. The first one that I have here is High Impact. So I'm just gonna swatch it right here. Very nicely it is swatching, and this is the shade of High Impact. This is kind of a maroonish kind of a shade. The next one that I have here is Extra. It is a mauve pink kind of a shade. If you can see, this is Extra. Then I have here Romance. I'm just gonna swatch it here. A beautiful nude shade. And then I have Hype. Let's just swatch it again. A very nude brown shade. This is Hype. To be honest, it just glides onto your skin very beautifully. It does have a very beautiful pigments as well. Today I'm gonna use Romance on my lip. I'm gonna just line my lips and fill my lip with Romance. So this is how Romance is looking on my lip. I truly love the color. Now K-Beauty also does have matte lipsticks. This is how the matte lipsticks looks like. I only have one color from the matte lipstick because I truly love this color. This is Papped. This range comes in 24 different shades and each lipstick will cost you 799 rupees. I'm just gonna grab the PAP. It does comes in a revolving kind of a packaging and I'm just gonna grab this one and apply this. I feel like this is a perfect nude shade, so that's why I tried. Totally love this shade. Super matte and super pretty shade. This is Papped and I truly love this shade. So the one thing that I don't like about K-Beauty products are their packaging. To be honest, all the products look the same. So if you have so many products that I have here with me, you get so confused that which product is which. The eyeshadow, the color corrector, the lipstick, and the eyeshadow looks everything the same. You cannot say this is something different or this is this. Also, the product name which are mentioned are only here. It is not even mentioned it is a lipstick or a eyeshadow or something like that. Only the shade name of the product is mentioned. And I think it is so difficult to figure out which product is which. Now it will just pick up all the products that I have here. It looks all of these pencils looks the same. It is so difficult to figure out which is which. Now again, the packaging on every product is like this. You'll get this product and then you have a plastic wrapping around this product. Now when you want to peel this off, you have to peel it like this, and it is so difficult. Like, it does have a area to peel it off, but products like this, lip pencils like this, I kind of destroyed this lip pencil while I was trying to open the package. And this, the plastic packaging is still here. It did not peel off. It takes a lot of effort to open the packaging, and sometimes doing so you also end up creating a mess of the product. So if somebody from K-Beauty is listening or somebody from Nykaa team is listening, please try to change the packaging of the product, at least the the plastic covering of this product. At least just place this or make this sticker smaller, the white one, because it is very, very difficult to open any K-Beauty product. I'm still trying to open this up. So yeah, finally it is now fine. I get it. It's very good that they have a protective layering on top of it so that it is making sure that it is unused and it is a brand new product. But to be honest, the packaging, taking off the packaging is a task. So if somebody is listening, please be more creative with the packaging and create a packaging which is more easy to open. So guys, that's all about the product review of K-Beauty. I have so many products from them and I hope you like this review. If you do like the review, do give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel. Do not forget to hit the bell icon as well so that whenever I'll post my next video, you'll get a notification. Also, do not forget to follow me on all of my social media handles where we can talk and chat a lot about what is going on, what do you want me to create more videos about, and everything else. If you really like the video, do share it with your friends and family so that they also will see this review and get to know about K-Beauty products more. So guys, thank you so much again for watching this video. I'll see you in my next video. Till then, bye.